pretty much down. What inspired y'all first to even want to own a club or promote a club?
Yeah, everybody's gonna have a different story.
Right, I want to hear the stories.
Yeah. Three, four different directions.
See, knowledge.
We're gonna go with knowledge first.
Okay.
Yeah, I started out, like you said, just getting into, I always mess my money up in the strip club. I always just say, one time I want to come from this side of the bar to the other side. So I got into it. My first one was Gold Rush.
Right. Okay.
It was the old Mirage. Anybody from here, Mirage. Right. I was the first one under the Gold Rush name when it changed. And that's when I got my feet wet. But then I went in with some guys who wasn't really, I think we was all new to it and wasn't rooted right.
Right.
So if you ain't rooted right, your base ain't strong, you're going to crumble.
Right. Right. So you got no foundation.
We all done chopped at it before. I done chopped at that, I done chopped at Trophies, which is now big old club on Phillips. That was nice. I mean, I done chopped. And I came up on this, and we just kind of blend together. It's just weird how that ain't like we just came up.
Because it's wild to me, because, you know what I'm saying, to be in a spot with so many club owners and promoters, just kick it. Like, that what y'all, either y'all partnered up or y'all just kicking it like a motherfucker. Or a little bit of both.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because most niggas in the city, it don't be that way. Them niggas really on some, I'm trying to outdo you type shit.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So this one real competition. It's competition. Yeah, so this some real dope shit. You know what I mean? So we got you into the game.
Shit, to be honest with you. Shit. I started off doing like a lot of concerts.
Okay. So you came in promoting then.
Yeah. Like, I went there with, like, a party promoter. I just always do shows.
What would you like best, parties or shows?
Shit, really, a party, it's a smaller gamble, but when you're doing concerts, you know what I'm saying, that shit go to looking crazy at the end of the night, and people want their bike in.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's when I got on side to the club side, because, shit, I'm tired of renting. I got to rent out the venue.
Right.
Give me 10 ones.
Pay for the artists.
Right.
So that's what really got me.
And for y'all don't know what a back end is, what happens is to book the artist, you got to give them a certain amount up front. Then the back end is what they pick up once they show up to the club.
Add their money, add that bike in.
Add that bike in. You don't want to be named as a junkie promoter.
Know what the bike is. They know what the bike is. But that's the lace them up.
There's a lot of junkie promoters around here.
Man, look here. I got 100 of those stories too, but I got to hear at least a couple of y'all's, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to that shit.
Let me call my dog.
He can tell you best. I can call my cousin Fat Boy, he'll tell you.
He's just played that move with Jenkins with Moody.
Yeah, so.
What's some of the artists you book?
Don't bitch a Fat Boy. He's just Jenkins, man. Motherfucker.
We done did Jeezy, Rich Homie, fucking Pooh Sheisty.
We just brought one about Rod
Wade.
Rod Wade. Motherfucking
Let me ask y'all this. I mean, y'all fucking around for real, so ain't that shit crazy, right? How your artists come out today and that nigga number go up so motherfucking fast these days?
Shit, who you telling? Shit, Rod Wade. Shit, we paid $12.5 for Rod Wade. Rod Wade.
He had just dropped the first single, probably.
Man, shit. How many days later that we tried to book him again when he came?
It went about a month or so later. That motherfucker wanted 30,000.
And
then
he
wanted
80,000,
and then again he wanted
100,000.
Just that.
I got hit like that for August Alcina.
I did August Alcina too.
For 10.
We was the first one to bring August Alcina to Jacksonville. Dej Lo. I was the first one to bring Dej Lo here.
That's some dope shit.
Pooh Sheisty, Fuji.
That nigga was 10, right? Then the remix came out. This shit ain't even 2 weeks yet. The remix came out. That nigga went to 100. You know, I guess it's different with the singles.
Yeah.
But shit. I want to hear, like, the Pooh side. Who you had the most fun working with? Or was the easiest to work with?
The most fun I had working with, he big, but he's not really big like that, though. But I say the coolest artist who hung out was Derez Deshawn.
Well, that's one of my favorite artists, man.
Man, listen, Derez Deshawn came into the show, right? The show was over. He took the liquor we gave him. He walked around to every VIP, gave everybody shots.
That was
so. As the show was over, we were going to. We bust down what we had to bust down, get back in though. I'm gonna leave. I look over. This nigga still in. I'm like, what's
so you caught the back end after he performed.
No, we came his back
end. You talking about the bust down between all
the part between.
Okay, gotcha.
So I come back out. We finna leave. He still there. He like this. He like, but what we doing?
He ready for after parties and shit.
I remember to go home with shit. Guess we hang out. He said, I said, where you want to go? He said, man, I want to go some ratchet shit. So we took that shit, the whoop, the whoop.
If y'all don't know the whoop, boy, that's ratchet.
Hey, let me tell you how cool the nigga is, right? Let me tell you how cool the nigga is. The nigga did some shit I probably wouldn't have did, you know what I'm saying? So we in the whoop, we chilling. We got a little session, got a little bottle and shit. We chilling the whoop, the whoop. So the chick, they called my phone. So I'm like, so they're like, what y'all doing? I said, shit, we got, what's the name? So they're like, well, we have a little pool party. So I said, I got the red to show. And she's like, quit lying. I said, the red Sunday girl got a pool party, a private pool party. You want to go? They go, yeah, let's go. So he got his little crew. We got our crew. We got in the car. Now, this shit on the north side now. North side of Jacksonville.
Yeah.
We go to a pool party on the north side of Jacksonville. Nigga's so cool, bro. We get there. They take up all his clothes and get in the pool with the hoes.
Oh, he don't give a fuck. Like, yes,
it's about like, now it's about 4:30, 5 o'clock. My girl, so she's like, I'm ready to go. So I'm like, I'm ready to go too. She's like, we're just winding down now. So I tell her, hey man, we finna go, man. They're like, man, I'm hanging out. See, I catch y'all, I'll let y'all later. Shit, we love it, you know what I'm saying? I talked to him about a couple days later. They're like, yeah, we had a blast, bro. You know what I'm saying? Y'all wanna do something, so.
He just gave, that's a fucking classic goddamn story right there.
Yeah. That's the Duval, coolest artist, man. The coolest
that is
artist.
Dope.
Oh, the Duval, man.
That's some dope shit.
Yeah.
Now you named a lot of artists. So I don't wanna ask you. You ain't gotta say no name you want to. But who might have been hard to work with?
Jeezy.
Shit, okay. I feel you.
Yeah, Jeezy. Jeezy asshole.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that shit was finna get real. You know what I'm saying? You know, it wasn't so much Jeezy. It was like his head security guard. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, he was just doing too much. And you know what I'm saying? Like, for all y'all rap niggas don't know, you can't come to Duval and think you just gonna leave with that money.
Yeah.
It ain't going down like that. You're going to perform or you ain't leaving.
A baby can get it, but a gorilla can't take it.
The itch was my old school.
You know, right there, rapper, right.
But yeah, that nigga he do it.
So what you saying? He got paid and didn't want to perform?
No, he got mad about a situation that happened earlier when the driver went to pick it up. You know, I tried to make the shit go smooth as possible.
Right.
But the security guard thought he was going to be able to talk to a nigga in the kind of way. We ain't going for that shit. We spending money with y'all.
Right.
Shit, he ain't coming this bitch to do this show for
really,
free.
Really, this shit'll work for hire.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so.
Folks don't look at it that way. That's really what it is.
He ain't motherfucking cheap at the same time.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, and he came. So his manager was calling me in the back, wanted to talk to me. But I really didn't have no problem with Jesus. You know what I'm saying? It was so, the security. So, long story short, he ended up coming on. And I guess Jeezy's right-hand man was telling the security, one of his partners, he was like, man, the security was saying, Jeezy's right-hand man said the security can't never come back. He was going to let Jeezy know when they get back to where they city, wherever they from.
Right.
Because he was like, them niggas in this town will kill you for the shit what he was doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just like he was just up there just on some muscle shit. Like, I don't know what the fuck his problem was, but I guess he was just trying to press Jesus to keep his job or some shit. I don't know, but
doing too much.
Yeah. That should be, it be like that sometimes. A lot of times, I don't work with a lot of motherfuckers. And
Plies another hard one to deal with.
But ain't it funny how most of the time, it don't be the artist. It be somebody around.
It's the brother. You know what I'm saying?
So it's Gates.
It's Gates.
Rich Homie.
It's hard to deal with. Like,
oh,
they kept our money. That's why I tried to tell them, because you know.
So what you do when you said they kept your money, where they kept your front end?
Yeah. They didn't, like you remember during the
pandemic?
Yeah. Uh-huh. He supposed to do it. You know how it was open up slow and shit. Right. So we tried the shit. And, but it was pouring down raining.
Right.
So he was telling us, because we had an outside show, because you know, nobody really could do shit inside.
Right.
And,
that social distancing,
so
all that stuff.
So he telling us to send the money. Like, man, I'm not going to send no more money unless you guarantee us another date. We already see that it's going to be a storm.
Say what?
Like, he played those type of games. So, a couple months later, Boosie had did a show at Onyx, the old spot I used to have. I had some partners in that. And they wanted to bring Plies with Boosie.
Right.
I told him, man, Plies can't come here and get no another check. Right.
I feel you.
I'm gonna go do that now. How can I let him come get another back in and you ain't straight me?
Right.
I ain't going for him to fly. So they end up boosting them. which is Shaw, Boosie manager, they took him off the show because they already know. I told him, bro, if y'all bring him,
it's gonna be an issue for real. Yeah, it's gonna be a real issue for real. So,
that's just like,
but that's the part of the thing that the people don't see. Yeah. All they see is when they come out and have a good ass time at the concert. Yeah, they don't know what a nigga
go through with these motherfuckers because these niggas be prima donna like a motherfucker, man.
It be that way.
They claim they be real street niggas and shit. A lot of niggas scary as fuck.
That's for damn sure. They be scared, for damn sure. Like, I done had situations where I done booked niggas and they ain't even damn sure. They ain't even want to get out the car. They was so spooked because of the way niggas is. You know what I mean?
I'm gonna tell you, real niggas that done came. We did shows with Fredo Bain. That's a real nigga.
That was about
Boosie. Them niggas real.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like.
Just like an extra partner.
Rollo Rodriguez, that's a real nigga.
I fuck with Rollo shit. Who did you, like I was asking him, which artist?
No cap.
My sons love No Cap shit.
You don't
like the camera? Yeah. What artist did you have the most fun doing? Y'all gotta remember now, you know what I'm saying? Like I say, we really live in the club. These niggas really working, getting it in.
Hey man, it's all the way live. Duval, KINGSOFTHENIGHTLIFE, man. So everything goes on this one.
I never really talked to the artists, to be honest.
Yeah, you did more with the management.
Like far as like once I straightened they back in, I don't really care to take no pictures. If I had the most fun I had probably was with Pooh Sheisty, that's the most money I made.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
You called it fresh hot.
Yeah.
So since you've been promoted, who's the artist that you got for the lowest and made the most?
Great fucking question.
I say Webbie.
Webbie.
Yeah.
So how much you got him for?
You ain't got to say the number to give a round number.
No, I want him to say the number. No,
Webbie, the number. Fuck it, it's Kings of the Night.
Webbie, we paid him $12,500.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was back in the day.
No, that was like not too long ago.
Not too long ago?
January last year? January last year. No, 20.
No, before pandemic?
No, right after the pandemic was over.
Okay.
I think it was 2021.
Okay. So January 2021.
Yeah.
And how much you made off the show?
Made like a 50 ball.
Oh, that's sweet, that's a flip.
Hey, man, you fucking right. You invest 12, man, and get 50 back, man. This the man you need to talk to, man. This man invest $12,000 and got 50 back, man. Where you can do that at?
Pooh Sheisty. Right. I broke the bank with Chase.
I believe it. That nigga was on fire.
He just like, he don't really, that's the only artist I took a picture with, him and Trina. Out of all them shows I ever did, I never took a picture with no other artist.
I'm that
besides
way too.
Tokyo, but she from the home team, so.
Yeah.
You know, but.
At the crib.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, but other than that, now, Pooh Sheisty, that nigga daddy cool as fuck, though.
Yeah.
Probably rolling with him, huh?
Yeah.
Now, on the strip club side, it's totally different. So, basically, you know, a lot of folks don't know how strip clubs actually work. They don't even know that, you know what I'm saying?
See, strip club, that's not really my thing.
Right. I'm just using an example. You know strip clubs. So, a lot of people don't know that dancers actually pay to dance. A lot of people don't know that.
That's called a bar fee.
Exactly. And they have to tip out the DJ. They have to do other things. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So, it's a profitable business.
Everything pays in the strip club. ATM, the pool table, the door. I mean, to get in as a male to come in. The girls pay to get in and dance. So, everything in a strip club is money. Your money make money.
Now, in Georgia, you have to find an existing license. They won't let us open new strip clubs. Is it like that in Florida?
No. Yeah. You just got to grease some palms. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of shit, they don't want to let a lot of shit, because it's a lot of violence and shit going on here. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you got to know somebody.
That would be.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
he pull some strings for you, you know, to get some shit going. Like, especially a brand new spot, that's going to be hard as hell to do. It's going to take you some money.
For all y'all tuning in, if y'all don't know, we got some real legends in the city right here. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir. Kings of Nightlife, man.
Yeah. These some real kings right here. Like I said, they do this shit for real. You know what I'm saying? And it's always a good situation where we can utilize, you know what I'm saying, I guess, to give an opportunity to school you. on how to get some, you know what I'm saying, get a check too. You know what I'm saying, when it comes to the nightlife, you know what I'm saying, overall, which he just gave some hella game. You know what I'm saying? He just basically, he just told you how to spend 12.5, nigga, and goddamn flip that bit to 50.
But sometimes, you could get a cheap art, but you got to put that work in. You know what I'm saying? You got
that work being?
Like, promoting. Mm-hmm. You got to get them flyers out there. You got to grind.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But see, like, Webbie is like Boosie in Jacksonville, too. You know what I'm saying? Them niggas, they love Webbie and Boosie in this motherfucker. They've been like that since I'm 18. I'm 38 right, now. Right, you know right. what I'm saying? So,
yeah.
But at the same time, you still got to grind hard. You can't just throw a show out there because a motherfucker hard and think a bitch going to show up.
Right. Man, look at here. I was at a Crow Nest. I used to do the Crow Nest on Old National.
Right.
And goddamn, we had that shit popping so crazy. A nigga got hella lazy, right? Ain't even going to flex. I got so lazy. Cause damn, my weekends were so good. The week was so dead. The motherfucker got down.
Control for Raina.
For who?
Raina.
But the goddamn, you know, the bar back, nigga.
She ain't camera shy. Right.
Hey, we got one of the ways. What's your name? We want to introduce you to Kings of Night.
Crystal, how are you?
Yeah, this Crystal. Crystal. Hey, I'm the Kings of Night. Like, yeah, I got a quick question for Knowledge. So with you being one of the majority owners, what would you say your hardest job with keeping the whole staff and the whole team together as one, that's functioning as one machine?
Openness. And when it comes to that money, man, you got to be open.
Right.
You got to treat the man 2% like you got 80%.
You right, I feel you.
Like you, just as much as you.
That was real.
You know, big eyes in this thing, man, right. You're going to fail.
Right.
So if you fuck with them enough to bring him in $2 of your money.
Would like them, so.
I'm saying if you fuck with somebody enough to bring him in on $2 of your money, you gotta treat like it's 85% of your money.
They're right.
So, you know, that's how.
And that fell. That's fell. You know.
And here
I'm
you
saying.
Don't know who the boss. So most time I'm back here. They right. Don't see me out front. So everybody play their role.
I would take some real shit. Nigga told me. You know when a boss really a boss? When goddamn he could be with everybody else and nobody thinks he's the boss. When they can't tell who the boss is. That's when the nigga doing it motherfucking right. You know what I'm saying?
That's because the reason why they, I feel, my opinion of that, what you just said, is because the boss is making sure that everybody on the team eats. So
right.
You can't establish who's the boss because everybody all of them eating properly. See, and that's what that means.
That's real
boss
shit.
You have to break
shit.
It down to this audience that we got watching us, man, because sometimes we say things and it seems simple to us, but it gets real right. Technical to the other people because they're not where we're from.
All exactly. All my partners, what saying, you know, if it's a problem, you need to go see Phil. It's a problem, go see Stanley, go see Connor. Go
right.
See, you know, it's not like on one man decision.
Right.
Everybody play their role. Everybody the boss of the area.
Right.
I'm the boss of the back room.
Everybody got their special.
So anything moving in here, it comes out there, I go ask them, man, what's happening over here?
Right.
What's happening
over right. there? Ain't no micromanaging. Ain't no micromanaging.
Step outside your ring.
Right. Everybody stay in their lane and everybody lane gonna run smooth.
Yeah. That right.
Like the Olive Barn.
Right. That right. Right. Let me ask you this. Now we finna kinda get a little technical, right?
Yeah.
Because the business is about drive, hustle, and getting to it. And we judge what we do every day on one day. In the nightclub industry, folks don't know that. Mm-hmm. What's the most you ever made in one night? That's the question.
Well, by us having a couple spots, I can combine about 100 racks.
100,000, nigga. That's what I'm talking about. That when you know you're getting to it. You know what I'm saying?
Hey man, this why we got them on Kings of Nightlife.
That's
man.
King
they,
shit.
They running the king. They the kings of the nightlife.
Right.
So you know what I'm saying? They would. One thing about this show, man, we ain't gonna have you on it, man. If you ain't running where you at.
Right.
Man. And that's why we got him here, man. That's why we got LaFia here. That's why we got Lil Stanley here.
And they in action. Y'all see the shit happening.
We run. This a circle, man. Everything running smooth like an oil chain, like an oil machine,
yep.
Man. The Kings of Nightlife, man. We in Duval County, man. Stand the fuck up. We here, Duval.
Yeah. So shit moving like it supposed to move. So he telling us we ain't got about like 5 more minutes. So goddamn, we finna down. You got something to ask?
Hey man, I I enjoy being back in Duval. This is my hometown, man.
Yeah, yeah.
And I just said I want everybody looking out for that VS Barker, man.
Right.
And we're gonna start off with putting it in first and goal. Gonna be the first place you can get it, and then you'll be able to get it in all the surrounding bars.
We want to make sure we say that again. First and goal.
First and goal.
With the address.
First and goal. 9150 Bay Meadows Road. 9150 Bay Meadows Road in the Ramada Hotel. That's gonna be the first place you can get the VS Vodka, man. If you ever in Duval County, if you're not from Duval, if you're in Duval, tap in, man.
And first we about to show you. We about to show y'all what first and goal look like on a motherfucking Sunday. That would make it crazy.
You already know it's all the way up today, man.
That's what make it fucking crazy.
Man. We're gonna take the cameras in there. And get some footage so we can bring that to the podcast, man.
Yeah.
Show y'all how they get down the first and goal. Hey, but I wanna thank y'all for tapping in, man. We got knowledge, man. We had Lil Phil, we had Lil Stanley, man. The whole first and goal cast, man. You know it's Big Vert, man. And we got Slab, Kings of Nightlife. Hey, we out here, man. It's up.
Yeah, yeah. Y'all already know what it is. I definitely wanna say I appreciate you taking the time. You know what I'm saying? Cause nigga, you a busy nigga. This. Y'all see
hey, we gotta get 100 views. We gotta get 100,000 views on this one, man.
Definitely.
We're gonna get 100,000 views on this one, man. I want 100,000 views on this one, man.
We going all the way up.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You know
yes,
what
sir.
I'm saying?
I'm back in Duval, man. Duval, stand the fuck up, man. I told y'all I was gonna bring this shit here. We here, baby.
Literally. We here.
Yeah.
And it's going all the way down. So the last thing we're gonna say is this here. Appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
You know what I'm saying? Now we want to push each other to be better, to get more. It's a lot of young niggas I see out here that's trying to be promoters, and they take niggas like us that's been doing it forever to show them the way. You know what I'm saying? Or show them the play.
Hey, man, you know what I'm saying? The game so, is to be sold, not to be told, man. All right. You gotta do is sit back and watch, man. The only way I want to tell all the young guys out there one thing, man. It's coming from me, man. The only way to be a good boss, man, you have to be able to be a good follower. You can never be a good leader until you was a good follower.
Exactly.
You can't skip that part and go straight to the boss and think you're going to be a good boss.
Right. It don't work.
It don't work because you're not going to know how to treat your workers.
Right.
You know what
that
I'm saying?
That's one of my main rules. I never ask a nigga to do some shit I wouldn't do my damn self.
Exactly. Or you haven't done your damn
right.
Self. Shit.
Hadn't done.
Ask him to do. You haven't done it.
Damn shit. Right. You know what I'm saying? So.
That's what it is, man. This Kings of Nightlife straight from Duval, man. First and goal, man. If you're in Duval, man, tap in. First and goal, man.
Yeah,
we back here in the office, man. We gutter like that, man. We
going
to the
office.
And get in, man. You know, I know y'all seen us in the big studios when we all in the big studios.
Yeah.
We got to go in there with the, you know. Nigga,
we finna be in these clothes on
there. They don't want us to smoke weed in there and all that cool and shit. You know what I tell them? I don't want to be in this studio, man. We can't smoke in here, none of that shit. The podcast boring.
Yeah, yeah. You know so we're going to do it like this. This your boy Big Slab.
And this Big Vert, man.
This Kings of the Nightlife.
And we got knowledge, man. And we out of here,
and
man.
We out.
Yeah.
Hey, a black bear off the fur candy.
And give me a black bear love out of that. Hey, give me a black bear love out of that refrigerator.
This nigga crazy.
Hey,
man.
Kings of the Nightlife.
Kings of the Nightlife.
Big Vert.
Who? It's your city, but we know you run this bitch.
Hey, man.
Show us how you get that.
Hey, we at first to go, man.
Let go,
man. We at first to go, baby.
Did you grab a...
Oh, shit. That's a weird shit.
Take the rub off. Told her right. it ain't no pulling out. Look at all the money on me. Everything brand new on me. Roller came with paperwork. I can't walk outside the store unless we test the diamonds first. Take out his paperwork. He can't get down with the game. We gotta check him first. 20K cash on me. Bitch, I got that bag on me. Pound the ticket for the Gucci slippers with the tag on them. Know I love them groupin' hoes. Pussy wet like snotty nose. Trout open, we got plenty of bull. We the reason that your trout slow. Pistol at the Pico. Strap inside the car seat. Bitch, I got the raw with me. Know these niggas kiss and tell. Shit begin real creep. Know I love them thirsty hoes. Come here, baby, swallow me. Pussy so good, take the rub off. Told her ride the dick, it ain't no pulling out. Look at all the money on me. Everything brand new on me. Roller came with paperwork. I can't walk outside the store unless we test the diamonds first. Take out his paperwork. He can't get down with the game, we gotta check him first. I don't rent the money off. Like four chicken, Elohim, independent. That's another ticket. Money real silly nice. Doing what I want to. Laughing to the bank. Money blue. Look like Blue's Clues. She don't want to run 100 balls. Bitch, I on the check. Get the puss up on the side. Told her that's a different way. I'm the type to beat the puss and leave. Ain't got them caught in it. Take the rub off the first night. You know I'm into that. Puss so good. Take the rub off. Told her I had a dick. It ain't no pulling out. Look at all this money on me. Everything brand new on me. Roller came with paperwork. I can't walk outside the store unless we test the diamonds first. Take out his paperwork. He can't get down with the game. We gotta check him first.